Good afternoon. In my previous video, actually we discussed about all theoretical aspects in connection with depreciation. I told you people what is the meaning of depreciation, what is depreciation. Continuous reduction in the value of fixed asset is known as depreciation. It is because of its normal usage. If we are using same asset for a long period of time, year by year, the production capacity of that particular asset is decreases, known as depreciation. I told you people some of the features of depreciation, such as it is only applicable to fixed asset and it is always charged on the original, it is charged on the cost price of an asset. And I told you people that the amount of depreciation should be treated as loss and it must be transferred to profit and loss account. And the next thing is the total amount of depreciation should not exceed the net value of an asset. So like this, we have discussed certain features of depreciation. Further, I told you people what are the reasons or what are the causes for depreciation, such as normal wear and tear, then lapse of time, then change in technology, then mishandling of an asset. These are certain important reasons or causes for charging depreciation. Later, I told you people about methods of depreciation. That is a straight line method and written down value method. These are the two methods that are used for charging depreciation. As we all know that straight line method is also known as original cost method or fixed installment method, and written down value method, it is also known as reducing balance method or diminishing balance method. What is a straight line method? It is a method where every time we are going to charge the same amount of depreciation. That method is known as a straight line method. And what is written down value method? It is a method where only first year we are going to charge depreciation on the original value of an asset, and for further years we are going to charge depreciation on written down value of an asset. What are the features of straight line method? Amount of depreciation will be remain same for all the years, and once the estimated life of an asset comes to end, the value of asset will become zero. That method is called as a straight line method. What is written down value method? Written down value method, it is a method where the amount of depreciation will be differ from year to year. And the second thing is the amount of depreciation will be in a decreasing trend. And third thing is the asset value will never become zero under written down value method. So in this particular video, we are going to solve some problems on depreciation. Here I am taken one problem and I am going to solve this particular problem under both the methods, that is a straight line method and this written down value method. First, let us read this question. Smart company purchased a machinery costing rupees 1 lakh, costing rupees 1 lakh on 1st January 2013. The rate of depreciation to be charged was at 20% per annum. Write up the machinery account and depreciation account for 3 years, ending 31st December. Under fixed installment method and under reducing balance method. First, what you should know is what is the cost price of an asset. The cost price of an asset is how much? It is 1 lakh rupee. And asset is purchased on 1st January. So every year we must charge depreciation on 31st December. Understood? Then what is the rate of depreciation? 20% is the rate of depreciation. What is the rate of depreciation? 20% is the rate of depreciation. 20% it is the rate of depreciation. Yes, this is what they are given in the problem. And they are asking us to prepare which account? They are asking us to prepare machinery account and depreciation account for 3 years under fixed installment method and under reducing balance method. So first let us solve this particular problem under fixed installment method. Fixed installment method is nothing but which method? It is nothing but straight line method. Straight line method is also known as original cost method. So let us write here solution, that is preparation of machinery account and depreciation account for how many years? For 3 years. Under which method? Under straight line method. Under which method? Straight line method. Straight line method. Yes. Straight line method is also known as which method? Yes, straight line method is also known as fixed installment method or original cost method. So first account that we need to prepare is, it is which account? It is machinery account. So first we need to prepare machinery account. Yes, in the center of the line, you people should write machinery account. And later on the left hand side, you should write abbreviation of debit. On the right hand side, you should write abbreviation of credit. Without fail, you people must write it. Okay, later. Yeah, how many columns will come? Actually, four columns will come on both the side. Four columns on the debit side and four columns on the credit side. So totally, you people need to make eight columns for preparing which account? For preparing machinery account. Just a minute. Yes. Like this, you people should make totally eight columns for preparing machinery account. Here, first column is meant for recording the date of the transaction. Second column is meant for particulars. Third column is meant for journal folio. And fourth column is meant for amount in rupees. Further, similarly, date, particulars. Then this column is meant for journal folio. And this column is meant for in rupees. So like this, you people should make format of which account? Machinery account. See here. Now, yeah, Smart Company purchased a machinery costing rupees 1 lakh on 1/1/2013. So first, you people should make an entry for purchase of an asset. What is the journal entry for purchase of an asset? Yes. Here are the journal entries. Here are the journal entries for purchase of an asset. Asset comes in, cash goes out. So asset account debited to cash account. So asset is what here? Machinery. So for purchase of machinery, journal entry is machinery account debited to cash account. So machinery account is debited. Yes. When that asset is purchased, it is purchased on 1/1/2013, right? So machinery comes in, what goes out? Cash goes out. So machinery account debited to cash account. Journal folio column is nil. Yes, machinery is purchased for how much? Rupees 1 lakh. Okay, further. Next thing is, yeah, it is purchased on 1/1/2013. So when we should charge depreciation on this particular asset? We should charge depreciation exactly after 1 year. That is on 31st December 2013. So what is the journal entry for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debit, second journal entry. For writing of depreciation or for charging depreciation, journal entry is a depreciation account debit to asset account. Asset is nothing but a machinery account. So here in this particular journal entry, machinery account is credited. So move towards credit side of the machinery account. Write down by depreciation account. Which account? By depreciation account. Okay. Now here you people should show that how you have calculated the depreciation. See here. What is the rate of depreciation? 20% is the rate of depreciation. On how much? On original cost of an asset. Straight line method. No? 1 lakh rupees. So 20% on 1 lakh rupees. How much? Yes. How much it is? 20,000 rupees. The amount of depreciation for the first year. Understood? Okay. So like this, you people should charge depreciation. Understood? Yes. Further. Now what you people need to do is, you people need to close this account now. What is the total of debit side? It is 1 lakh rupee. Same total you people should take it on the credit side. It is also rupees 1 lakh. It is also rupees how much? 1 lakh rupee. Now you people should find out balancing figure. What is the balancing figure? 80,000 rupee is the balancing figure. What is this 80,000 rupee? This 80,000 rupee is closing balance. It is closing balance on 31st 12 2013. So for closing balance, what you people should write? For closing balance, you people should write by balance carried down. What you should write? By balance carried down. Understood? Okay. Now this is closing balance of which year? 2013. It will become opening balance to 2014. So now you people should write here 1/1/2014. 14. Okay. Opening balance, no? For opening balance, what we should write? We should write to balance brought down. To balance brought down. How much is the opening balance? 80,000 rupees. See here, the closing balance of 2013 will become opening balance for 2014. Understood? Okay. Yes, fine. Now, again, in the year 2014, that is on 31st 12 2014, we should charge depreciation. So what would be the journal entry for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debit to asset account, that is machinery account. So machinery account is credited. Move towards credit side of machinery account, right? Right, by depreciation account, by depreciation account. Understood? Now, what is the amount of depreciation? See, a rate of depreciation is 20%. 20% on straight line method, no? All the time you should calculate a depreciation on original cost. So 20% on 1 lakh. 20% on 1 lakh. So what is the amount of depreciation? 20,000 rupee will be the amount of depreciation. Understood? Okay. Now again, what we need to do? We need to close this particular account, right? Yes. Okay. Which side total is more? Debit side total is more. That is 80,000 rupee. Take the same total on the credit side. It is 80,000 rupee. Now what you need to do? You need to find out the balancing figure. What is the balancing figure? 60,000 rupee is the balancing figure. What is this 60,000 rupee now? This 60,000 rupee is closing balance. So on closing date of the year, that is 31st 12 2014, yes, closing balance it is. For closing balance, what we should write? We should write by balance carried down. By balance carried down. How much? 60,000 rupees. It is how you people need to prepare. You people need to prepare machinery account. Okay. So they are asking us to prepare 3 years machinery account. No. So we done with 2013. We done with 2014. Now let us move with 2014. Yes. Again, 2014 closing balance will become opening balance on 2015. So 1/1/2015. Yes. What we should write for opening balance? We should write to balance brought down. Yes. How much is the opening balance? 60,000 rupees. The opening balance. Again, at the end of the year, that is on 31st December 2015, again we need to charge depreciation. So what would be the journal entry? Every year journal entry is not going to same. Understood? So what would be the journal entry for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debit to asset account. So asset account, that is machinery account, is credited on the credit side of machinery account by depreciation account. By depreciation account. Now how to calculate the depreciation? It is 20% on, again, 1 lakh rupee, original cost method, straight line method. All the time depreciation should be calculated on this particular figure. So 20% on 1 lakh rupees, how much? 20,000 rupees. I told you people, know what are the features of straight line method. Amount of depreciation will be remain same for all the years. See here, first year 20,000 rupee, second year 20,000 rupee, again third year 20,000 rupees. So amount of depreciation will be remain same for all the years. Yes. Now what we need to do? We need to close this particular account. How to close this particular account? See here, you people know the procedure for closing of an account. You should make total of debit side or credit side, whichever is higher. Which side total is more? Debit side total is more. That is 60,000 rupee. Take the same figure on the opposite side. It is 60,000 rupee. What is the balancing figure? 60,000 minus 20,000. 40,000 rupee is the balancing figure. What is this balancing figure? Actually, it is closing balance. For closing balance, what we should write? We should write by balance carried down. And when you will find this particular closing balance? You will find it on closing date of the year, that is on 31st 12 2015. Understood? Yes. Now, yeah, they asked us to prepare machinery account for 3 years. So we're done with the preparation of machinery account for 3 years. That is from 1/1/2013 to 31st 12 2015. Now one more step is remaining. That is, always we should end ledger accounts by writing the opening balance of next year. So let us write the opening balance of 2016, that is 1/1/2016. Yes, for opening balance, what we should write? We should write true balance brought down. Yes, how much is the opening balance here? 40,000 rupees, the opening balance. See here, the closing balance of 2013 becomes opening balance for 2014. The closing balance of 2014 will become opening balance to 2015. And the closing balance of 2015 will become opening balance to 2016. It is how you people need to prepare which account? Machinery account. Under which method? Under straight line method. Under which method? Under straight line method. Straight line method is also known as fixed installment method, or it is also known as original cost method. It is also known as original cost method. Yes. Let us continue with next account. Yes, they asked us to prepare totally two accounts. One is machinery account and another one is which account? Another one is depreciation account they asked us to prepare. So now we'll prepare a depreciation account. In the center of the line, we should write the name of the account, that is depreciation account. Okay. On the right hand side, on the left hand side, you should write abbreviation of debit. On the left hand side, you should write the abbreviation of debit. And on the right hand side, you should write the abbreviation of credit. Okay. Here, the format will be remain same for all the ledger accounts. So now we are preparing depreciation account. Yes, let us make same kind of format for this account also. Which account it is? Depreciation account. Yes. Like this format is going to appear. Four columns on the debit side, four columns on the credit side, like date, particular, journal, folio, and amount. Okay, let us start. See here, for preparing asset account, you people should know two journal entries. One is purchase of an asset, and second journal entry is charging of depreciation. And for preparing depreciation account, you should know second journal entry and third journal entry. That is charging depreciation and transfer of depreciation. Okay, let's start. You people will understand, and preparation of depreciation account is not at all a difficult task. It is very simple aspect, right? Okay, here in this particular account, we are going to write or record the amounts that is written off from the value of an asset. I mean, we are going to record the amount of depreciation. For the first year, when we have charged depreciation, we charged it on 31/12/2013. Okay, fine. What was the journal entry for charging depreciation? For charging depreciation, journal entry was depreciation account debited to asset account. It was depreciation account debit to assets account. So here is the depreciation account. Depreciation account is debited when you have charged depreciation on 31/12/2013. So depreciation account debit to which account? To asset account. Asset account is nothing but to machinery account. Okay. For the first year, how much depreciation you have charged? 20,000 rupee depreciation you have charged. Understood? So in this particular account, we are going to record depreciation. We are going to record depreciation that is charged on the asset. Okay. Yeah. Now, after charging depreciation, you should transfer that depreciation to profit and loss account. So what would be the journal entry for transfer of depreciation to profit and loss account? Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So in this particular journal entry, that is third journal entry, depreciation account is credited, right? It is credited. So on the credit side of depreciation account, again, you should write the same date, 31/12/2013. Yes, what you should write? You should write by profit and loss account. By profit and loss account. Understood? Yes. How much depreciation you have transferred to profit and loss account? 20,000 rupee you have transferred to profit and loss account. Now this particular account will close. Both the side total will be 20,000 and 20,000. Understood? Okay. Similarly, again at the end of the second year, that is on 31/12/2014, you need to charge depreciation on machinery. What is the journal entry for charging depreciation on machinery? Depreciation account debit to which account? To machinery
account to machinery account. Yes, tell me, for the second year again how much depreciation you have charged? Again we have charged 20,000 rupees. Straight line method, no, every year we have charged 20,000 rupee depreciation on the value of fixed asset. So to machinery account 20,000. Again, this 20,000 rupees should be transferred to which account? It should be transferred to profit and loss account. So what would be the journal entry? Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So depreciation account is credited here. On the credit side of depreciation account, what you should write? You should write profit and loss account. What you should write? You should write profit and loss account. So for the second year, how much amount of depreciation is transferred to profit and loss account? 20,000 rupees in transfer. Understood? Yes. Okay. Now let us move to third year. Entries will be remain same for all the years. What is the third year now? It is the 31st 12 2015. For the third year, we charge depreciation on 31st December 2015. For the third year, we have charged depreciation on 31st 12 2015. Yes, what is the journal entry? Again, a depreciation account debit to which account? To machinery account. To which account? To machinery account. Yes, for the third year also we have charged same amount of depreciation, no? That is rupees 20,000. And this 20,000 rupee should be transferred to which account? Should be transferred to profit and loss account. So what would be the journal entry? Profit and loss account debit. Profit and loss account debit to which account? To depreciation account. So depreciation account is credited on the credit side for profit and loss account. How much? 20,000 rupees. Understood? Yes. Again, this particular account will close. Both the side total will be how much? 20,000 rupees. Keep in mind, with the depreciation account, you are not going to find any balance. Every year, this account is going to close by transferring the amount of depreciation to profit and loss account. So it is how you people need to prepare machinery account and depreciation account under which method? Under straight line method. Keep in mind, under straight line method, amount of depreciation will be remain same for all the years, because every time we are going to charge depreciation on which? Depreciation on what? Depreciation on original cost of an asset, that is 1 lakh rupees. Understood? Okay. Now we prepare machinery account and depreciation account under which method? Under written down value method. I will show you people that how we should prepare machinery account and this which account? Depreciation account under which method? Under written down value method. Now B. Actually here we are having two questions. No, A is under fixed installment method. B is preparation of machinery account and depreciation account under which method? Under written down value method. Yes, let us prepare the account. Yeah, you should write abbreviation of debit on the left hand side, and later you should write the name of the account, that is machinery account, right? Then you should write abbreviation of credit on the which hand side? On the right hand side, credit. Understood? Yes, you should prepare account like this. How many columns are going to come? Totally 8 columns will come. 4 columns on the debit side and 4 columns on the credit side. Am I clear? Yes, like this you people need to prepare which account? You people need to prepare machinery account. Yes, let us start now. See here, entries will be remains the same whether it is a straight line method or written down value method. The only difference is how to calculate the amount of depreciation. Under straight line method, amount of depreciation will be same for all the years, but under written down value method, amount of depreciation will be differ from year to year. It will be differ from year. Yes. Let's see how to prepare this machinery account under this written down value method. As I told you people, amount of depreciation here, journal entries will be same, but the amount of depreciation will be
different. Understood? Yes. The way in which we are going to calculate a depreciation, it will be completely different as compared to straight line method. Okay. So again, we purchased asset. When we purchased asset, we purchased it on 1/1/2013. What is the journal entry for purchase of an asset? Asset comes in cash goes out. So what would be the journal entry? Machinery account debit to which account? To cash account. Machinery account debited to cash account. What is the amount? We have purchased asset for rupees 1 lakh. So machinery account debited to cash account rupees 1 lakh. Right? Okay. Now again, at the end of the year, we need to charge depreciation. So what is the date? It is the 31st 12 2013. What is the journal entry for charging depreciation? It is depreciation account debited to asset account. Depreciation account debited to asset account. Asset account is nothing but machinery account. Machinery account is credited. So on the credit side of machinery account, by depreciation account. Okay. Yes. Now, how to calculate the depreciation? Rate of depreciation is how much? It is 20%. 20% on what? 20% on rupees 1 lakh. Rupees 1 lakh. So, what is the amount of depreciation? 20,000 rupees the amount of depreciation. Understood? Okay. Now, we need to close this account. What is the total of debit side? 1 lakh rupee. Yeah, take the same total on the opposite side. It is rupees 1 lakh. Now find out the balancing figure. What is the balancing figure? 80,000 rupees, the balancing figure. What is this balancing figure? This is actually closing balance. For closing balance, what you should write? You should write balance carried down. And when you will find this closing balance? You will find it on the closing date of the year, that is on 31st 12 2013. Understood? Okay. Now, see here, under written down value method, only first year we are going to charge depreciation on original cost of an asset. From next year onwards, we are going to charge depreciation on written down value of an asset. So now, the closing balance of 2013 will become opening balance on 2014, that is on 1/1/2014. Yes. For opening balance, what we should write? We should write to balance brought down. Okay, what is the opening balance for the year 2014? It is 80,000. Again, at the end of the year, that is on 31st 12 2014, we need to charge depreciation. What is the journal entry again for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debited to machinery account. So machinery account is credited on the credit side of machinery account. By depreciation account, right? Yes. Okay. Now let's see how to calculate depreciation. Which method? Written down value method. Only first year you should calculate depreciation on original cost of an asset. From further year onwards, you should calculate depreciation on written down value of an asset. See here, this is the written down value of an asset. Understood? Cost price is 1 lakh rupee minus first year depreciation 20,000. So what is the written down value? 80,000 rupee is the written down value of an asset. Now 20% on 80,000. What is the amount of depreciation? 16,000 rupee is the amount of depreciation. 16,000 rupees. Understood? Only first year on original cost of an asset. From further year onwards, written down value of an asset. Understood? Okay. Now we need to close this particular account. Yes, total of debit side or credit side, whichever is higher. Debit side total is more, that is 80,000 rupees. Take the same total on the credit side, that is 80,000 rupees. Now, how much balancing figure you are finding? That is 80,000 minus 16,000. You are going to find how much? 64,000 we are going to find. 64,000. Yes, 64,000 is the balancing figure. Which balance it is? It is closing balance. Which balance it is? It is closing balance. For closing balance, what we should write? We should write balance carried down. Yes, on which date? On closing date of the year. That is when? On 31st to 12, 2000. Now, the closing balance of 2014 is how much? It is 64,000. It will become opening balance to 2015. What is 2015 now? It is 1-1-2015, opening date. Yeah. For opening balance, what we should write? We should write to balance brought down. To balance brought down. Yes, how much is the opening balance? 64,000 rupees, the opening balance. Again, at the end of the third year, that is on 31st 12 2015, you should charge depreciation, right? What would be the journal entry for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debit to machinery account. Machinery account is credited on the credit side of machinery account by depreciation account. By depreciation account. Now let's see how to calculate depreciation for the third year. How to calculate depreciation for the third year? Again, we need to calculate depreciation for the third year. Rate of depreciation is remains the same. How much percent it is? It is 20%. 20% on what? 20% on written down value of an asset. How much is the written down value here? It is 64,000. It is 64,000. See here, for the second year, written down value is 80,000 rupee. For the third year, written down value is 64,000. Now, 20% on 64,000. 20% on 64,000. So 64,000 into 20%. How much it is? It is 12,800. It is 12,800. Okay. Now we need to close this particular account. Yes, we need to close this particular account. Yes. Okay. Yeah. What is the total here? 64,000 is the total on the debit side. We'll take the same figure on the credit side. It is rupees 64,000. It is rupees 64,000. Let us find out the balancing figure. What is the balancing figure? Balancing figure is 64,000 minus 12,800. It is 51,200. 51,200 is the balancing figure. Okay. For this balance, yeah, what is this balancing figure? This is closing balance. For closing balance, what we should write? We should write by balance carried down. What we should write? We should write by balance carried down. And when you found this closing balance, you found it on 31st 12 2015. By balance carried down is 15,200. Okay. Now, yes, we should write opening balance for the fourth year, right? What is the date? 1-1-2016. What is the, yes, what we should write for opening balance? We should write to balance brought down. To balance brought down. Yes, how much? 51,200. Yes. What is your observation here? What is the difference between the straight line method and written down value method? Under straight line method, every year we were charging 20% depreciation on 1 lakh rupee. So amount of depreciation was 20,000 rupee for all the years. But under written down value method, we are charging 20% of depreciation first year on the original cost of an asset, and for further years we are charging it on the written down value of an asset. So first year we charge 20% on 1 lakh rupee, second year we charge 20% on 80,000, third year we have charged 20% on 64,000. Understood? 64,000. So it is, see here, you can find all the features of written down value method. Amount of depreciation is differ from year to year. First year 20,000, second year 16,000, third year it is 12,400. So amount of depreciation is differ from year to year. That is first feature. Second feature is amount of depreciation, it is decreasing year by year. First year 20,000, second year 16,000, third year 12,800, so on. Understood? And in this particular method, the asset value will never become zero. So it is about which method? It is about written down value method. Now we'll move towards next account. We have prepared asset account. Now, which account we need to prepare? We need to prepare depreciation account. Preparation of depreciation account is not at all a difficult task. Not at all a difficult task. Yes. Yeah. Write down in the center of the line, depreciation account. On the left hand side, you should write abbreviation of debit. On the right hand side, you should write abbreviation of credit. Yes, abbreviation of credit.
credit. Okay. And every year this particular account is going to close. Yes, very simple. One side what you people should write. One side you people should write to machinery account, and another side you people should write by profit and loss account. Let us start. And one more very important thing is, under depreciation account only closing dates are going to appear, not any opening dates. And another important thing is, every year this depreciation account is going to close. So for the first year, when we have charged depreciation on 31st 12 2013, what was the journal entry for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debit to which account? To machinery account. To machinery account. Yes. What was the amount of depreciation for the first year? 20,000 rupee was the amount of depreciation. Understood? Now this 20,000 rupee should be transferred to which account? It should be transferred to profit and loss account. So what would be the journal entry? Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So depreciation account is credited on the credit side of depreciation account by profit and loss account. Yes, we have transferred 20,000 rupee to profit and loss account. What is the total of this account now? 20,000 rupee on the debit side, 20,000 rupee on credit side. So this account is closed. Now let us move to next year, that is 31st 12 2014. Fine. Yes. Again, what is the journal entry for charging depreciation on asset? Depreciation account debit to which account? To machinery account. To which account? To machinery account. Fine. What is the amount of depreciation that you have charged on machinery for the second year? How much it is? It is 16,000. How much it is? It is 16,000. Right? 16,000 rupee. This is 16,000 rupee should be transferred to which account now? It should be transferred to profit and loss account. So what would be the journal entry? Profit and loss account debit to profit and loss account debited to depreciation account. Depreciation account is credited on the credit side of depreciation account by profit and loss account. By profit and loss account. How much? 16,000 rupee we should transfer. What is the total of this account now? 16,000 rupee. 16,000 rupees. Now let us move to third year. That is, third year is 31st 12 2015. Yes, again we need to charge depreciation. What is the journal entry for charging depreciation? Depreciation account debit to which account? To machinery account. Yes, what is the amount of depreciation for the third year? Here it is, 12,800. Now this 12,800 rupee should be transferred to which account? It should be transferred to profit and loss account. So what is the journal entry? Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So depreciation account is credited on the credit side of depreciation account by profit and loss account. Yes, how much we should transfer? 12,800 rupees should be transferred. Yes, what is the total of third year? 12,800. Understood? So it is how we need to prepare asset account and depreciation account. The only thing is, you should know what is the difference between straight line method and written down value method. What is the difference? Under straight line method, every year we are going to calculate a depreciation on original cost of an asset. Understood? That is 20% on 1 lakh for all 3 years. But under written down value method, we are going to calculate a depreciation first year on original cost of the asset. For further years, we are going to calculate it on written down value of an asset. So these are the written down values of an asset. Second year 80,000, third year 64,000, fourth year 51,200. Understood? Yes. So this is all about how we should solve problems on depreciation. If you people are having any kind of queries on solving problems on depreciation, you people can approach me by sending messages on WhatsApp. I will address your queries. Thank you so much. Hope you people understood both the methods. In my next video, I will cover bank reconciliation statement.